adenocarcinoid. And I was flown to New York, and in Sloan Kettering, I was operated upon. I had hemicolectomy. It was in the appendix. And I had to pay at that point in time thousands of dollars from my pocket. And I wondered how many people in my country can afford this kind of expensive treatment and I said, not very many. Well, when I came back, mercifully I had lease of life, so came back to Pakistan, and I was elected the Chief Minister of Punjab, and we, built, hospitals dealing with kidney, liver, cancer, both by the governments, various governments, and philanthropists. Without going into details, that is the point of issue. That today, I think the first and foremost problem is global inequity. Now, look at COVID. It exposed these imbalances, gaps, hugely. Imagine global north and global south, distribution of north and global south. Distribution of vaccines and so on and so forth. Two, climate change has completely changed the landscape. Pakistan does not contribute, even Afghan does not contribute, even a fraction of emissions, yet we are on the list, red list of climate change, and in 2022, we experienced the worst climate change floods in Pakistan, devastating everything from hospitals, schools, lands, agriculture, everything. And we had to invest hundreds of billions of rupees to rehabilitate people. But when it came to the question of seeking funds from abroad, though those were loans, expensive loans, can a developing country afford that? Three, if you want to use your meager resources to provide access to decent health care to the people, wherever there's a way, there's a will, there's a way. That's my belief. And there's a way. That's my belief. And as Chief Minister of Punjab, I, by the grace of God, was able to provide in the far nook and corner of my province. It's a province of 140 million people. Wonderful hepatitis facilities in every remote area of the province, provided with CT scans, all over the province. Poor people who are very in dire need of providing food and education to children cannot waste time. So I provided CT scans in their area. Which were the reports uploaded, brought to big centers of Punjab, and then the experts would look at that and send back the report in the evening, and they would get medical facilities. Three, I was able to, by the grace of God, built one of the finest hospital for kidney and liver in Lahore. which is probably the best in South Asia, which is probably the best in South Asia. And, you know, poor people going to India, to China, you know, expensive treatment we offered them in Lahore, saving very, very, you know, scarce foreign exchange and getting them free treatment who are poor, and we would charge treatment who are poor, and we would charge who are rich. And this combination of cross subsidy, we were able to provide facilities to the people. And then dengue in 2011, it struck Pakistan, and most of all it struck the city of Lahore. And he would bear me out, this dengue outbreak was probably the biggest around the globe. I have to confess here in front of this August Assembly, I didn't know much about dengue. Believe me, we collected experts, and then, you know, from 6 in the morning, till late night, I would have meetings. It was the entire government, and civil society, philanthropists, experts, doctors, and common man, we all got them together. Went for lava, these brigades would go out and this find where is in a lava and trying to finish them through modern techniques. It was a challenge of sorts. I got machines flown by aircraft and placed in hospitals and HDUs we established in all hospitals. And I, through a decree, you know, made it, in all laboratories responsible to provide these dengue tests. At a very meager cost. Mm.